Welcome to NetVN channel. In the previous video I showed how to monitor network traffic using MRTG. In this video I show you how to monitor processor load and monitor storage usage of Windows Server. Here I install and set up on my computer Windows 11. I first went to MRTG's homepage and downloaded its latest version. Then I extracted it to the C partition of my Windows 11 computer. I renamed the folder to MRTG. To use MRTG requires a Windows 11 computer with Perl installed. You can easily find the Perl download link in the documentation on the home page. To download and install Perl, you need to create a free account. Because I already have a free account, so I use it to download Perl. I choose the Perl version for the Windows operating system. I download the latest version of Perl for Windows 10. Here I was instructed to install Perl using the command line. As instructed, I just copy and paste this command into the Windows 11 command prompt to install Perl. On a Windows 11 computer, I open a command prompt and paste the command as instructed. After pasting the command and pressing enter, it will take a few minutes to download and install Perl. Notify me that Perl has been successfully installed on Windows 11. Now I create a new configuration file for the Windows Server. My target Windows Server has SNMP enabled and configured. You can easily find how to install SNMP for Windows computers on the internet. Or you can refer to the videos on my YouTube channel. I put it in the description of the video. You open the command window and go to the folder called bin of MRTG. You use the command as above to create a configuration file for the target server. You just need to update the IP address of the target server. And here is the configuration file I got. I will open it with Notepad software to edit. I add the top two lines of the config file. The first line specifies where to save the monitoring results. By default, MRTG only fetches monitoring results once, with the second line that will help me get monitoring results every 5 minutes. I created a new folder named www. Then in the folder named www I create a new subfolder named MRTG. This folder stores Windows Server monitoring results. Later I will open this folder and get the monitoring results. The default config file only helps me to monitor the network traffic of the target Windows Server, so I edited the config file to be able to monitor processor load and storage usage. Before configuring storage monitoring, I set up processor monitoring. To monitor the processor, I need a software to get the necessary information of the target Windows Server. The software I recommend you to use is iResoning MIB Browser, because it's free and easy to use. It has a paid version, but for needs like in this video you only need the free version. I download it and install it like any other software. After completing the installation, I open it and look for the information about the target server's processor. Here you enter the IP address of the target server. In this case the IP address is 192.168.1.254. You can find the processor load information with the OID I have prepared here, or browse the catalog on the right side of the software. Both methods give the same result. In this example I use OID to find the processor load. As a result, my processor has two cores and has a load of 9% each. If your processor has more cores, then you can set the same. After getting the above information, I will edit the configuration file as follows. I copy and paste the above sample text to the configuration file. Then I update the information as follows. I update the IP address of the target Windows server. Next, I update the OID of each processor core. You just copy and paste OID. Copy and paste the OID of the first core of the processor. Copy and paste the OID of the processor's second core. So I have successfully updated the configuration file for processor load monitoring. Next, I monitor the server storage. It helps me to know if the server is overloaded in storage or not. Just like last time, I use my browser to find information about target server storage. On the server there will be many types of storage, so I need to find out and choose which storage to monitor. Here is the target server storage information. I'll set it up to monitor the Windows server's internal storage first. To monitor the internal storage, I need to know the size of the internal storage and how much is currently being used by the server. As here, the internal storage has a sequence number of 3 out of 3 types of server storage. Actually, your server may have more than 3. I update the OID according to the used storage and the size of the internal storage. Next, I update the IP address of the target server. When the result is received, the result is multiplied by the allocation unit. You get the allocation unit on the MIB browser software. I finished monitoring setup with internal storage. Next, I will monitor the C partition of the Windows server. The method is similar to monitoring internal storage, but this storage has a serial number of 1 of the 3 storages. You update the used storage OID and the storage size of the Windows Server C partition. Next, I updated the server's IP address like before. The result I get I multiply by allocation unit. The allocation unit of this storage has a value of 4096. The target server's configuration file is done, I just need to save the changes. Next, I will execute this config file using MRTG. I go to the folder called bin. Here I open a command window to execute the configuration monitoring command using the tool MRTG. The command to execute is perl mrtg in the config file name. Every 5 minutes the MRTG tool will get the monitoring result once. You can refer to the previous video to know how to use the MRTG tool without a console window. Or refer to how to set up to run MRTG every time you start Windows operating system. Finally, we just have to wait for the results of monitoring of the target server's processor, storage and traffic. You use any browser available on your Windows computer to check the monitoring results. Above are the basic steps to monitor Windows server. Good luck, don't forget to like and subscribe. And this is the result I got after a while of monitoring and found that the server is working fine. The processor uses an average of 10%. The internal storage uses about 2 GB, and the free storage of the C partition is about 40 GB.